then once you check the whole panel, then just scuff around that. That makes sense? See, either you gotta get down on the floor, check out the panel, make sure it's good, because what's gonna happen is if you scuff it, and I go fix all the damage, I'm not gonna see it, and then when I paint it, it's gonna look like crap. Make sense?
Yeah.
Right. So if you're gonna do it, that's all you gotta do. You gotta find all the dents, make sure you get whatever light you need, put on the dents. Because I need to buy some more lights. I gotta go to Harbor Freight. Harbor Freight, you owe me some advertisement money. I gotta go to Harbor Freight and pick up some of them. These lights, because they're pretty bright.
No, they are.
I have to learn to stop cursing. That's one of the biggest things you're going to learn.
Did I just curse again?
When?
Yeah. Did I really? I didn't realize it.
You didn't because your vocabulary is a little bit weak.
It's a little, no, it's not weak, it's just kind of weak.
Yeah?
It's a little bit of an outlook.
No, it's just weak. What about that? I see a bubble. Oh, yeah. Look. Head on. So you always have to look at the panel at an angle.
Alright.
So for instance over here is a little bit less lighted because of where the light sits. So when you clean off this panel, come over here so I can show you. See, like if you look, you can see the light, right? This is too bright. But you see this light? You see that one from there? The shadow? So you can actually follow it all the way down. So sometimes the bright light don't ever help you enough.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Sometimes it takes a glare. So you need the glare off of the light to really see. You don't need the direct light because then you're never gonna see the damage.
Yeah.
So you need the reflection because the reflection show dents. Reflection show shades and shadows.
Yeah, that's like
painting or shade.
That video that I'm showing you with the pebble pool. That lighting.
Yes.
That's
yes.
What they were doing.
Yes. So you use shade or shadow to see the dents. And that's how you see the imperfection. That makes sense?
Yeah.
Because if you look dead on at the dent, it might look good.
Yep.
But then when you bring it outside and you start walking around a car and now you're at different angles, you gotta say, holy crap, look at that. You want the tape smaller, so look, it's like this, not good. You want the tape to be like this, so it stays. You want to just put tape, because when you start scuffing, the scuff pad, like this even good. You know what I'm saying? That's good. But when you're doing here with it sticking up, no. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? Glenn is the dent police. You can't be like, yo, you can't pull over again. I'm gonna fix it out.
I see three dents.
But that's what you do, Glenn. That's the first start of fixing a dent. You gotta find it. It's like the customer normally shows it.
Customer normally doesn't see all the dents.
But because this is a complete paint job?
Everything.
Huh?
Everything.
Well, you're never gonna get every dent on a paint job, I don't think. You know, you always miss something.
But it's not good to miss it, obviously.
Well, this is what my rule comes. You get a customer agree on fixing, say, this, whatever the damage is, and I see other damage, and it's not gonna cost me nothing more to fix the damage, I'm gonna fix it because down the road, God forbid, I'm doing something. And say, for instance, anything can happen.
Yeah.
And the customer say, "Oh man, you messed up right over here." But I mean, you know, they're gonna look at it and say, "You know what? He took the effort and fixed everything."
So I'm not
gonna be too upset that you messed up a little thing or whatever it might be.
No, it's a
you know, so it's a give. I think for me, first. situation because you ain't never. I try to be 100% good. I'm always coming up short. Wonderful. You know, I'm not an ace viewer. No, but you get what I'm saying. So you always try to go above and beyond.
Yeah.
Just because when you do mess up, it's not like holy moly. You say you were gonna do this and that, and then all of a sudden
you do this.
Yeah. So it's always over exceed people's expectations. That's what I say. I don't know. I can't explain it. Over exceed people's expectations. And if you don't. Body work is supposed to, I mean, nobody want to hear this, but they pay insurance and be like, oh, you know, you got paid a lot of money, but they don't see this, like now, Glenn, if you record this and show it what it really is and how much work goes into it, and this is actually, we're not even doing a full-blown teardown. I am paying them. This is like, some panels ain't coming off because we don't want to break certain.
Not that she don't love me. Not that that she wouldn't stay with
you. Yeah, but if you're not a progressive person, why stay with you?
If it wasn't for her daughter, she probably would be more lenient to my lifestyle and what I was doing.
Nah, she would have never talked to you.
She would have never talked to you. Before her daughter, before my kid, we talked to each other. We had.
She would have never talked to you.
Anyway. Her daughter, like my daughter, she don't want her daughter calling him and daddy, who ain't calling me the real daddy.
No, put it this way. I think the fact that her value went down when she had a kid and left a baby daddy.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I think her value went down.
Oh, so I got to change.
What?
Trust me, her baby daddy was so less than me.
I don't care what happened. What's wrong with
you? I'm not even sure.
Once a woman has a kid and leave the man?
He knocked her teeth out.
Okay.
She was pregnant.
Does she have a police report for that?
She got a report.
Does she have a police report for that?
What? Does she?
Yeah.
Yeah, they have a report. You know the victims, their mothers and shit? They have a report.
One of those?
Yeah, because the hospital, they said they lost the birth certificate because the father put the baby's address as his address. They knew that she was being beaten and stuff, so what they did is lost it, was still coughing, and had her come back, filed, put her address down, and he came back to sign it. So now, when she left him, like, right out of the hospital, she went to her parents' house. Never went back to his house or nothing. He couldn't call nothing because of legal residence of the baby's at the mother and father's house.
Oh.
So.
That was a slick move, and I bet you a woman did that. Women stick together, I tell you.
Yeah, how is a female nerd? But. Being the fact that everything happened the way it is, she really has this thing where my daughter's my everything, even though he doesn't give a shit, he's not in the picture now, she didn't want her risk, because she didn't take his rights away from her. She just said, this
she
is
don't want to be with
him. No, and you got supervised visitation because you're untrusted. And he's also got little sexual misconduct on his record, too. So, being all that, she would never let her daughter alone with this man. She don't want to give him the risk of it. And she ain't going to sit there and have anyone risk
it. I don't think no man is going to do that to him. Well,
Come on. You can't even say that because today's world, there's some sick fucks out there.
And there you go again. Cursing. We had a long conversation.
Yeah, that episode on the whole area.
No. Glenn's going to have to just say, Todd again. There goes Todd again.
There's a Todd.
Don't be a Todd, people.
Don't be a Todd.
Yo, that would be crazy, right? I could come over to her commercial and it's not one no more Dave.
No more Dave. Don't be a Dave. Don't be a Todd.
Yeah, don't be a Todd. That'd be funny. Because that's... Oh,
are you
Todd? State Farm, right? We're State Farm with a Dave.
No.
Look up what commercials, don't be a date. job on that job search?
No, the job. No. Commercial's
the commercial is about a job. Like,
oh.
Search for job.
Like, there's someone you want to hire.
Okay. Oh, it was a job search. Oh, okay. Hey, Dave, you've gotten a bad rep for it. Sorry.
Don't want to hire Dave. The dryer sheets in my boots.
Nah.
Go to work. Do whatever I got to do. Then I take it off?
No, your feet stink though?
They do. I try them on.
Bad?
No, not like you gotta make the rules.
Do you change your socks every
yes.
day? Every day.
Every day. I do not put the same dirty socks on.
Every day you change your socks.
Every day. That's why I got so many socks.
Alright, so start when every time you take a shower at nighttime?
No, son.
Get a wet towel. Wipe down your poop with alcohol. My brother.
Yeah, but.
My brother did, but didn't stink, but he used to sweat a lot, and he had split. He had split toes. You got split toes too?
Not split toes. I know my toes are close together.
No, but you get split toes, like in between your toes, like raw, split.
Sometimes.
Yeah, so, because when you take a shower, you don't clean your foot.
I do. But that's
clean
my problem.
Between your toes?
My boots, I need
you
air
clean
in boots.
Between your foot.
Yes. Because I got now. Ever
and
since
then
Chelsea.
This is the next time. Next question. Do you change your shoes at least once or twice a year?
Yes. But that's my. No, here's the problem.
That's my problem.
My feet and my hands sweat a lot. I have a sweating deficiency. I sweat more than the average person. So, unless I got aerated boots that breathe.
Nah, I think you probably just need two pair of shoes.
I do. I need more than just what I got.
Yeah.
I have been living good.
I think because you're wearing your shoes morning, noon, and night, the same shoes. Like, I buy shoes from Walmart.
Yeah, $20.
Nah! I'm like a Fred Flintstone, $10 a pair. Shoes is like brakes. They rub off quick.
I don't get it. I get dirt a lot.
Nah, so I buy Walmart shoes. Well, shoes from Walmart with memory foam, $10 a pair. And I literally change my shoes every month, 2 months. I literally just throw them in the garbage at Walmart, put them in a new pair, and pay for it at Walmart. Literally.
Yeah, well, you know, works.
No, because what used to happen was, my foot, I used to get a lot of corn on the side of my foot, but I used to be like, what the hell should I do to fix that problem? Because I'm on my foot all the time.
Yeah.
And I said, memory foam? Because I used to spend like $80 on a pair of shoes, so if I spend $100, it's still cheaper because it's $10 a pair. I don't know if that make any sense, but that's what I think it does.
Financially, it's better.
So for the year, I might wear, for the year, I might buy 10, 15 pairs of shoes.
No, not.
About 8 pairs. Yeah, about 8 or 9 pairs of shoes for the year.
That's a lot more than me.
Huh?
That's a lot more than me.
No, but I'm buying, there's like $10 a pair. With memory foam. So anytime. Like, I realize my big toe, anytime they start to hurt, and my pinky toe, time for a new pair of shoes. Huh? Because I'm on my feet all day.